Hello everyone, welcome back to the next lecture in the computer network series, and today we will see the Go-Back-N ARQ. As usual, let's start the session with the outcomes. In today's session, we have only one outcome. And what is that? Upon the completion of this session, the learner will be able to understand the working of Go-Back-N ARQ. So in today's session, we are exclusively focusing on the Go-Back-N ARQ. Before going into the details of Go-Back-N ARQ, let's revisit the sliding window protocol. We know sliding window protocol is different from the traditional stop and wait protocol. In stop and wait protocol, only one frame is sent at a time and the sender will not send the next frame without receiving the acknowledgement for the previously sent frame. Whereas in a sliding window protocol, group of frames, that is multiple frames, can be sent at a time. The variations of sliding window protocols are Go-Back-N ARQ and Selective Repeat ARQ. And the topic of the day is Go-Back-N ARQ. Let's see what is Go-Back-N ARQ in today's lecture in a detailed manner. In Go-Back-N ARQ, what is this N? This N is the sender window size. Suppose if we say Go-Back 3, then 3 is the sender's window size. It means 3 frames can be sent at a time before expecting an acknowledgement from the receiver. If it is Go-Back 5, then 5 frames can be sent by the sender to the receiver before expecting an acknowledgement. Shortly, we are going to see an animation. At that time, we will be able to understand what is this N and what is the significance of this N. Let's see the theoretical aspects of Go-Back-N ARQ. The Go-Back-N ARQ, it uses the concept of protocol pipelining. That is, the sender can send multiple frames before receiving an acknowledgement for the first frame. Suppose if we have 5 frames and if the concept is Go-Back 3, then 3 frames can be sent. Frame number 1, frame number 2, frame number 3 can be sent before expecting the acknowledgement for the frame 1. There are finite number of frames and the frames are numbered in a sequential manner. We know this Go-Back-N ARQ is going to send multiple frames. We need to distinguish one frame from other frames. So obviously, we need some numbering approach. These numbers are called as sequence numbers. And that is why the point which is mentioned here is the frames are numbered in a sequential manner. And the next point is the number of frames that can be sent depends on the sender window size. We know this N is the sender window size. And the number of frames that can be sent is this N. What if the acknowledgement is not received on time? If the acknowledgement of a frame is not received within an agreed upon time period, all frames in the current window are retransmitted. Suppose if we have sent frame number 5 and we didn't get the acknowledgement for frame number 5, if the current window is holding 3 frames and all these 3 frames are retransmitted, please understand, this is a very important point in Go-Back-N ARQ. When we see an animation, this point will be very clear for you. Please make a note of this point. All frames in the current window are retransmitted if the acknowledgement of a frame is not received in time. Let's see some more details about this Go-Back-N ARQ. The size of the sending window determines the sequence number of the outbound frames. Suppose if there are 10 frames, the sending window size is 2, then the sequence number will not be like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Since we have 10 frames, we are not just like that numbering all the frames as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like that. The sequence number of the frames is also decided by the sending window size, that is this N. We will see an example, then it will be clear. We know N is the sender's window size. For example, if the sending window size is 4, that is, here this N is 4, then the sequence number will be between 0 and 3, that is, from 0 to 3, the frames are numbered. How this is done? If the number is 4, it can be written as a power of 2. So 4 can be written as 2 power 2, where this 2 means this is the sequence number bits, that is, the binary bits. If the number of binary bit is 2, then 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Its decimal equivalent is 0, 1, 2 and 3. And that is what it is mentioned here. If the sending window size is 4, that is 2 power 2, this 2 is the number of bits in the sequence number. That is, In decimal, they are 0, 1, 2 and 3. Suppose if we have 10 frames, then this sequence number will be repeated for all the frames like this. 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1 and so on. I hope now you understand what is this power 2. This 2 is the number of bits in the sequence number. So the number of bits in the sequence number is 2, that is this 2, is to generate the binary sequence 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. Its decimal equivalent is 0, 0 means 0, 0, 1 is 1, 1, 0 is 2 and 1, 1 is 3. And we can reuse this sequence number as per our requirement, that is the number of frames. Let's see the working of GoBackN ARQ with an animation, then it will be more clear for you. Suppose if we have a sender and we have a receiver, and let's assume that there are 11 frames to be sent and the frames are numbered as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Please note the sequence number, actually this is the sequence number of the frame. And this sequence number is decided by the window size n. For better understanding, I have taken a running number. But actually, if the number of bits in the sequence number is 2, then this would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2 and it goes on. But for understanding purpose, I have taken a running serial number. Now, what is the sender window size? Let's take the sender window size be 4. It means 4 frames can be sent by the sender before expecting an acknowledgement for the first frame, that is frame 0. Let's see it now. The sender is now sending frame number 0. Now what is there in the current window? In the current window, only frame 0 will be there. Now what happens? Sender will send the next frame because the sender can send a maximum of 4 frames before expecting an acknowledgement for frame 0. Now the sender will send frame 1, frame 2, and frame 3. So 4 frames are sent by the sender because the sender window size is 4. Now what is expected? The sender is expected to receive an acknowledgement for frame 0. Let's assume the receiver has sent an acknowledgement for frame 0. So frame 0 is acknowledged. So what do we understand from this? So frame 0 is sent and it has been successfully received by the receiver because receiver has acknowledged frame 0. Now what will be done by the sender? Now sender will send the next frame. What is the next frame in the buffer? The next frame is frame number 4. So frame number 4 is sent and if you observe, the window now slides. Can you see the window is now sliding? Because this is the frame which is sent and acknowledged. We need not worry about this frame anymore. And what is this? These are the frames that was sent by the sender and is still waiting for an acknowledgement. And what about this? These are the frames that are not yet sent. The receiver will now acknowledge for frame number 1. Let's assume the receiver has acknowledged frame number 1. Now what sender does? It sends the next frame in the buffer. What is the next frame in the buffer? It is frame number 5. So sender will send frame number 5 and the window now slides. Now let's assume the sender is not acknowledging frame number 2. Why? Because either the frame is lost, that is frame number 2 is lost, or the acknowledgement is lost. What happens in the sender side? The sender will wait for a certain period of time. If the acknowledgement is not received in time, what the sender does? It has to retransmit. So here the acknowledgement is not received in time. So sender times out. And what is the next frame to be sent in the example? It is frame number 6. But if you observe, frame number 2 is not acknowledged by the receiver. So sender understands that either the frame 2 is missing or the acknowledgement is missing. So the sender is now going back to 2. You just see, it's going back to 2. What is the starting frame in the current window? The current window is holding frame number 2, 3, 4 and 5. It is just going back to 2, which is the starting of the frame in the current window. I hope now you understand it is going back to 2. So from 2, what are there in the current window? All the frames are retransmitted. So frame 2, frame 3, frame 4 and frame 5 are retransmitted. If you observe, already frame 4 and 5 was sent by the sender, but the receiver discards these two frames. Why? Because it has not received frame number 2, so it discards all the frames that are there in the receiver buffer. The frame that was not received by the receiver was frame 2 because we assumed that frame 2 is lost. So frame 2's acknowledgement will not be sent by the receiver and there is no chance for the sender to receive frame 2's acknowledgement. So what the sender does, it is going back to the starting of the window, that is frame 2, 3, 4, 5 is the current window, and it is going to frame 2 and it starts retransmitting frame 2, 3, 4 and 5. Already frame 4 and 5 are transmitted, but still the sender will retransmit all the frames that are there in the current window. The frames that are there in the current window are 2, 3, 4 and 5. In this case, the receiver will ignore frame 4 and 5. And that's the working of a Go-Back-N ARQ protocol. I hope now you understood the working of Go-Back-N ARQ. In the next lecture, we will solve a problem in Go-Back-N ARQ. Thank you for watching.